Josh Minchell is judging the $30,000 six-horse hitch showdown today at the Big E. Josh, you came in all the way from Oklahoma.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, just in the nick of time, too. I almost missed my flight, so.
Well, we're sure glad you made your flight. Flying in just to judge this class specifically, do you feel that there's more objectivity in the judging because you haven't seen these horses the past few days?
Yeah, first of all, it's an honor to judge this class. It's a big class, and we have really competitive hitches here. But yeah, I think coming in and not having seen them gives a new perspective. When a judge has seen him all week, maybe he's got some things made up in his mind already. But coming in, I really don't know what I'm going to see today, and which is exciting. Puts a lot of pressure on me. I don't want to mess up one class, especially a class of this caliber.
You are the general manager of the Express Clydesdales, who in 2013 earned the world champion six-horse hitch under your direction. What are some of the things that you will be looking for in the hitches today?
Well, whenever you judge a hitch, you're looking for uniformity and a team that works well together. If you have horses that aren't working as a unit, then it's just not a good team or a good hitch. So that's first and foremost. You want them to work well. You want them to transition from the gates well, do their maneuvers well. But you're also looking for style and action as well. And then not only that, when you walk through the lineup, you want to see good conformation in the horses. So a lot of that all comes into play to culminate your final tally in your head.
Are you looking for unity in the horses actually stepping together? I mean, how can you as a judge put unity into words with a team on a hitch?
Yeah, well, I always say when you look at the profile view of a hitch coming down the line, you want to see three horses there. You want to see them not only stepping together but carrying their heads the same. You want to see the same kind of movement throughout the team. So yeah, because traditionally when these teams were working teams, that was the ideal situation. You wanted the team to work together, to go through their maneuvers together as a unit. So that's still important today.
You are widely recognized as one of the best drivers in the world. When you are judging a hitch, are you also watching how the driver is communicating with the team of horses?
Yeah, I'm not sure where you got your information, but I'm flattered, but I don't know if it's true. But yes, you are watching. I mean, you are watching the drivers a certain amount, because if the driver is struggling, usually the team is not performing well. So it goes hand in hand. You want to see a driver that's comfortable with his team, relaxed, not fighting them. So yeah, that comes into play a certain amount.
Have you, in your experiences, witnessed teams that actually outdrive the driver's capability, where the horses really are working in harmony despite what the driver is doing?
Sure, yeah, and I always say when our team is working well, they're usually tugging on me pretty good, because they're working together, they're, you know, pulling together, and it just seems like a little bit more tension on your hands. So yeah, sometimes it's a struggle just to hang on to all that power, but you don't want to be fighting them either. So yeah, I think that sometimes the horses can outpower the driver, and I've seen it happen quite a few times, actually. They're 2,000 pounds animals, and when you put six of them in front of you and you want them amped up and looking good, and when all of that comes together, it's a lot of power.
Yeah. Given that it is so much power, and I ask this question coming from a show jumping background, you know, when everything's in perfect harmony, it's just really light and you're sitting there enjoying the ride. Is there ever a lightness in the reins and the hands when the horses are working in harmony?
Yeah, sure, and it depends on certain people train their horses differently. Some of them want them tugging in the bit, and some of them don't. I'm particularly not that big, so I don't want them tugging too hard in the bit. I want them to be a little softer in the mouth. But sometimes to get the look that you desire, you have to get them a little bit more chargy and aggressive. So there's kind of a fine balance. You want them aggressive looking, but you don't want them too chargy that they're ripping you off the seat.
Now, the showdown has different breeds competing, and they have decidedly different proclivities and actions. How do you make a judging decision when it's a Clydesdale versus a Percheron versus, you know, a Belgian? How does that factor into your decision making?
Yeah, it makes it tough. Obviously, judging just one specific breed is a lot easier because you're comparing different qualities and characteristics to the same likeness. But so it makes it tougher. You need to take into account, all the qualities of each breed that they try to specialize in, or the uniqueness of the breed, and weigh them against each other. So it does, puts a lot more thoughts in your head, and you just have to think through it and try to make the best decision that you can.
In today's class, we have 14 entries, and theoretically, say there are four that really catch your eye for the top four teams. What are some of the little nuances that decide between first and second, second and third? Because from a layman's standpoint, they look beautiful, you know, from the stands. How do you make those decisions?
Yeah, it's going to be small things, especially at this caliber of teams. It's going to be little minute things. Could come down to one little mistake, or on coming down the line, or one horse make one little bobble that will decipher first from second. Because these are all, to be frank, they're all good teams. So it's going to have to come down to the little things, I'm sure. It could be confirmation in the teams that sets one apart from the other, because they both had a really good drive on the rail, a really comparable drive. So then you go to confirmation of the team, or other little things. But yeah, I'm afraid it's going to be small things that will set them apart today.
Does turnout play a factor?
Absolutely. And these guys, I know, all spend a lot of effort and time in the barn making sure everything's polished. But you do look at the turnout. You look at the cleanliness of the equipment, how well the horses are shod. So all of those things come into play.
Well, Josh, you've got your work cut out for you. Thank you so much for taking some time before the class, and we look forward to the results.
You bet. Thank you.